She made history as Cape Coral's first female mayor.
All of you continue to do what you do so great, which you do on Facebook.
Her public and private life on display for all of Southwest Florida to see.
As many of you know, some issues of my personal life have unfortunately become very public.
Tonight, her message to the people of Cape Coral as she moves out of public office.
Everything prepares you for the next chapter of your life.
Voters are choosing Mayor Sawicki's successor right now. She announced months ago she didn't want to keep the job.
Sawicki is leaving office while under investigation by the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, one of the many times her controversies made headlines over the past 4 years. NBC News' Dave Elias sat down exclusively with the mayor to find out if she has any regrets. Dave?
Yeah, Mayor Sawicki tells me that she has battled adversity, but she's also boasting her accomplishments. She points to things like lower taxes, more commercial businesses, reduced regulations, and online permitting. But the question tonight, will these be the things she's remembered for?
I think if I had been married coming in, it would have been different. But there was a different standard for me, given that I was a single woman.
It was 2013. Cape Coral elected its first ever female mayor. She defeated incumbent John Sullivan by just 120 votes. He demanded a recount and sued, claiming illegal votes made her the winner.
I don't know, maybe only 6 months in the entire 4 years that I haven't had something, either recounts going on for a year and a half or everything with my personal life.
She blames much of the controversy on the good old boys club. She calls this political cartoon proof.
It's still like that.
But it was no laughing matter when this happened.
Give it up. That's your phone. 911, what's your emergency?
Yeah, I'm leaving Mayor Marni Sawicki's house.
A 911 call revealed a tumultuous relationship with ex-husband Ken Retzer. She filed a restraining order accusing him of harassment.
Please respect my privacy as I work to resolve these very challenging personal issues.
She later married him. They divorced 2 months later in Glades County.
Everything with my personal life, I laugh because people say I'm the black eye, but I've got some council members that need to own that piece too.
Some council members were frequent critics of the mayor.
I have been crucified.
This meeting so heated, the mayor stormed out.
I don't need anything.
Opponents taking to social media calling for her resignation.
All I got to say is that,
sir,
mayor, you need to resign.
You're done.
You need
Thank
to
you.
Remove
Your time
from
is
office.
Up. Should I have you removed?
If this is the first time that I've had something come at me, I might say it's a distraction.
The distractions continued. Sawicki was accused of accepting gifts from then-boyfriend and StormSmart CEO Brian Rist in return for his company sponsoring the city's 4th of July event, a matter FDLE would eventually investigate.
If you're talking about all of this going on right now with FDLE, I think it's more about, a certain group in our community that had started saying things so long ago and none of it's come to fruition.
But claims of her ex-husband strangling her in a Miami hotel surfaced in June. He was arrested and charged. All of it enough for Sawicki not to seek a second term.
Any regrets?
No. And everything happens for a reason. And everything prepares you for the next chapter of your life.
For now, she's not saying what that will be.
Governor Sawicki.
No. Not government. No. Now activism, something in that.
Now, in fairness, while all of this was going on with the mayor, she did continue working, and she says that she's proud of getting city employees raises while remaining fiscally responsible, and she's proud of implementing, along with city council, a $6 million paving program. Live in the newsroom tonight, Dave Elias, NBC2.